Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Jay Madaan. I do a couple of things, Vastu is one of them, astrology, face reading, palm reading, your feet reading, all of it. But right now, let's read your office desk. What does it say about you, your mindset? What are the things that you should keep and what are the things that you should never keep? Let's talk about your working or your studying desk, your work area. Well, let's start it. The first and the foremost important thing that I want you to keep there is a bamboo plant. Why bamboo? Because it signifies growth. It can also be, you can have a bamboo in mud and you can have bamboo in water, which shows flexibility. That's how we should be when we are working, right? If I'm rigid, you can't connect with me. So there has to be flexibility in us, yet growth, right? So bamboo is very amazing. And of course, green things add so much to you. I love greens. Another thing, you should always have a little, you know, office table clock, but the way it should be facing is the person sitting across you should also be able to see it, and you yourself should be able to see it, so that time management is managed between two people. It should not be just stress giving to you or to the other person. It should be a common thing in between, right? So that the other person can also see and you can also see. Maximum things that you pick up on from your office table should always be on your left. No, you work from right? I know that. Why on your left? We have two pair of eyes, we have two pair of ears, legs, hands. We use our legs equally. Aisa to nahi hai na ki aap right pair se zyada chalte hain left se kam, or you look from left eye more and you say, well, I don't use my right eye more. That doesn't happen. We use them equally. But do we use our hands equally? We use our working hand most of the time and the other hand is non-dominant. That's not fair because the other hand is connected, the left hand is connected to the right part of your brain to make it more active. Like I have my pen stand on my left. I pick it from here and write it from here so that I use my left hand also a lot. I keep my visiting card holder here. I pick it from here and give it from here. So try and use your left hand as much as possible so that you balance both parts of your brain. Another important thing, if you use scissors or any sharp objects, you know, on your office desk, make sure it's always pointed down. This is scary. Suppose if I talk to you like this, isn't pointed things give us a lot of fear? So always pointed things should be facing downwards. Never your chargers should be attached to things. If you've charged your laptop, it's okay, let it go. Wires, a lot of wires, if it is already charged, it's not very great. It doesn't give a lot of positive energy to people around. You're seeing my desk, right? Now look at my desk. Could you feel the energy changing? Do you feel it still gives the same look or the feel? Well, that's what you do to your desk. If you have cluttered hair, you will attract more clutter, you will feel like a clutter and your whole life will become miserable. Make sure your desk is as clean as possible so that you attract good vibrations, you attract openness in life. Another most important thing, a lot of people have chairs where they actually bend back and work and relax. During work time, you should always be alert, and so does your employees be. You know, do we like staff who's laid back, chilling and doing nothing? Your body language should not be like this, nor like this, nor like this. It should be straight and erect because that's why we're working for. For that, you should always have a cushion behind your back, and the cushion should have a message. While we're walking up on the mountain, if somebody is pressing your back and making you climb up, we feel so relaxed, like that, maza aa gaya, right? So when you have a cushion behind your back, it's a support system that you have, right? So the cushion should have the message or a motivational quote or picture of your loved one or a picture of a god or a goddess that gives you a lot of support in life, or something which is very interesting. Let me show you my cushions. I use them sometimes on and off. Like this? Oh, yeah. So dollar and rupees. We work for money. There's no harm in loving wealth. It's a tool, but you should know how to use it. It should bring happiness and smile to yourself, to your loved ones, and also to the people whom you really don't know. That's the real purpose of wealth or money. You should have an interesting cushion, maybe with a motivational quote, picture, dollar rupee sign logo, something like that on your back, so that you're always sitting in an erect position and you're getting right support. With this, I would like to give you last tip. So let me give you the flashback. Green object, especially a bamboo on your office desk, amazing. Doesn't matter how big it is, even two stems does wonders. On your left, you should have maximum objects so that you use your left hand, no sharp objects, clutter-free desk, and also no charging points always connected to your gadgets, and foremost important, a cushion behind your back with a beautiful message, a picture or a logo or a goal that you're working for in life, and so that you sit erect, you're always targeted and you have immense back support. While I'm talking to you about the desk, it just reminded me in looking at the Ganesha just in front of me in my office. So let's talk about Ganesha in our next episode. Let's see what Ganesha is all about. Where should you place him in the house or in the office? What position? What is his purpose to be there in your house or in your office? We'll talk about it in our next episode. See you soon.